Inspired on Liberty Radio.
Welcome to Be Inspired. Here we are to inspire all of you once again and again and again, persuaded as many times as it's necessary.
That's right, Bishop. We are here in the faith to bless the people.
Yes. Are you ready to be inspired? Are you ready to see more fruits in the desert? Huh? What about yours? Who here you have already shared your testimony? Type here on the chat. Who here you have already sent your testimony to us? Let's see. Who did it? Who did it? Type here on the chat. If you did it, great. If you haven't, come on. Do it today. Many of you have testimony. Of course you do. Pastor Edward.
Yes.
Many of them sent me their testimony written down to my email. Hello, Bishop, and this is my testimony. I said, great. And then, please record your testimony. Never again I got a reply.
Oh, Bishop, come on, come on. We need to share
Well, let
my
me
video.
Just make sure that I am not in just now. I got some in the form of testimonies, but not even coming to me. It went straight there. Great.
Right.
They sent to the page my testimony.
Right.
But the majority, when I told them to record, it's like they ran away. My goodness.
We cannot be shy.
Look at
we cannot be shy in the terms of glorifying Jesus with our testimony. We have to do it. Inspire others.
People say, I don't know. I don't speak properly. You know, I'm not good on that. I'm not good on so many things as well. I don't even speak properly. English is not even my first language. See, if I, imagine if I thought like this, oh my goodness, English is not my first language. Now I'm going to make a fool of myself in front of everybody. You know what? I don't care. Adopt this method, the I don't care method.
That's right.
That means I don't care about what people have to say about me, their opinion. I don't care. I'm not being rude, or I'm talking about you saying this to yourself. And then you say, I only care about one thing, pleasing God.
That's right.
I'm doing this for Him, and this is it. I don't care about whether people are going to like it or not. I am doing this for my Lord. This is my offering.
That's it, Bishop.
For God.
We're not seeking for people's approval.
Isn't
we
it?
Don't need it.
We're not politicians.
We're blessing people. No. And as you said, if we were going to be perfect to do this, I would be the last one to be
Imagine.
Here, Bishop. Well, we are here using our faith, and
yes,
people can do
we?
The same.
Sometimes I look at myself and say, my goodness, I have to change so many ways. I'm a very, you know, like an instrument that it doesn't offer much to God.
No.
And still He uses us like this.
Yes, He does.
And the truth is this, Pastor Edward, God doesn't care. Now it's God saying, I don't care. I don't care if you have capacity or not.
Yes,
I don't care about your past. The moment you give your life to me and you repent, I don't care. Because God gives capacity to those He chooses.
Bishop, whether people speak in a perfect way or they don't speak good at all, if they know how to film something very nice, the star will be Jesus anyway. It's
always.
Not about us. He's
always.
The star, so
always,
let Him be glorified.
Always. If we look at the Bible, God used the underdog. God used the, you know, the Moses. He remember, low in
He's
speech.
He's stuttered, right? The leper.
The leper.
To save the nation. So many. Those
fishermen.
The widow. The poor widow.
Look at this. Come on. Come on. Can't you see it? Can't you see that God gives capacity to those He has chosen? And it makes sense, Pastor, because what if God chose people who were, you know, experts, you know, people who really knew how to do the work perfectly? The glory would not be His.
Yes,
that person would get the glory.
That's right.
But when we see a fisherman speaking like a, you know, an eloquent man, literate, imagine somebody who it seems like he went to Harvard.
Others were,
right?
were shocked, right? Someone like
amazing.
Gideon, for instance, who was there, the youngest of the poorest nation, family.
You see, about Gideon, it says that his family was the smallest.
The poorest. He was the youngest brother in the poorest family.
So the poorest
in Israel.
There were even levels of poverty.
Yes.
He was at the lowest.
He was below everybody.
So he was the least, right?
Yes.
He was the last
the least
one there.
Of the least, yes. And he said to God, I don't know, it can't be me. God said, it's you. It's going to be you.
And God used him. Can you see how great? And you who are connected there, God has chosen you. That's right. You are one of us. You are one of those who have been rejected, despised. You see, people don't really consider us as people who are, you know, people who have something to offer. Usually, yes. we are known as little people,
yes.
fanatics, foolish.
Religious.
But God has chosen us. God has chosen you. You who are there and you are saying, ah, who am I? Who am I? Stop saying, who am I? And start saying, here I am, my Lord. Here I am. And I don't accept my life not to glorify you. This is it. Do you know what many of them are like? In revolt, Pastor Edward.
That's right.
That's it.
That's right. It's true.
Because if they are shy, they have to revolt against this shyness.
Yes.
Because this is not according to God's will. God cannot use people who are shy. He told even Gideon, tell the fearful and shy to go home.
That's right.
But there is nothing I can do. Of course you can. You can go again. Of course you can do it. You can. You have to go against these feelings. Go against what is holding you back.
That's right. That's the only way, actually, to overcome the issue once and for all. It's like anyone who has an issue with heights, what do they have to do? They have to say, I'm going to go to a high place because it doesn't make sense. Anyone who is afraid of anything, they need to confront that fear. And what leads us to confront that is the revolt.
Yes. Revolt is what pushes faith to take us. No, revolt ignites faith. Imagine. Because faith without revolt is what? Good for nothing, isn't it? It's a dormant faith.
It's just theory.
Yeah, we can say it's theoretical faith.
Yes, it's just words. Yeah. Right, Bishop? It's just
revolt
talk.
Is the key element that makes the practice great.
Because revolt doesn't speak, Bishop. Revolt acts.
That's right.
It does. People just do it. They do it. I don't want to talk to anybody. Boom. They get it done.
See, revolt, as I was saying, is this moment that you say, I don't care about what people have to say or think. You see, you are not worried. You just know that you are there for God, and this is for God. And that's what matters.
That's it.
And that's what you have to do. You who have a testimony, go against your fears. Come on, get your phone. Get your phone. I'm gonna show them. Look. That's what you have to do. Can you see? I have to appear. I have, imagine, Pastor Edward, I have to be here and I have to put my face here for everybody to see. So, you know, nobody can see you. People can see me. Get your phone. And then, look. You record. Like this, look. Record yourself. You can do it. You can do it there by yourself, alone in your bedroom, wherever you want. Come on, are you afraid of what? Who is shy there? Who here you have been struggling with shyness or fears? Please, stand up where you are. Stretch out your hands to me here. Now, shout there. Ah! Do like this. Yes, go ahead. And say now, I'm not shy anymore. Are you doing it? Huh? Can you see shy people don't do that?
Yes.
And they can.
They can.
Can you see you are doing this? Do it. Do it. Say that, yes, I'm not ashamed. I'm not afraid. This is it. What is the problem? Do you know what is the problem? You are too much worried about what people think. What people have to say. That's the problem. Stop worrying about what people think and say. Have this understanding, what matters is what God thinks of me. And you're going to go far. We're going to go now for a quick break. Quick one. Let's go for a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to show you testimonies. Ah, Pastor Edward, today we have very nice testimonies.
Strong
people
ones.
Who believed and acted. And remember, you know, inject revolt in your life. Yes, revolt. Revolt, because this is what is missing many people's lives. Revolt. Say, I don't accept not to be able to do it. Why not? God is with me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Let's go in this faith. Huh? Share the link of the program with more people. Have you done it? You haven't done it yet? Come on. Share the link of the program and let's invite more people to join us. We're going to be playing testimony straight after the break. Let's go quickly. Huh?
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
Have you enjoyed using the Liberty Radio live chat? Or do you not know how to do it? It's easy. Just take the following steps. Come on. 1. Open the app. 2. You need to check what your name is displayed as by opening the menu. This is indicated by the three lines in the top left-hand side of the screen. 3. Once there, click on the gear image in the top right corner. Click on Change Name. If anonymous with some digits is displayed, just delete this and replace it with your name. 4. Save and return to the home screen. 5. You can now click on the red Join the Live Chat bubble as you're all set up to get chatting. 6. Please note, when you're logged into the chat, always remember to be nice to others. You can share your ideas, ask for advice, and even take the opportunity to make new friends. So come on, it's time to tune in to your favorite show.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
Welcome back. Let's now watch more testimonies, Pastor Edwards. Let's see the fruits in the desert. More people who are using their faith with us, they are not going by what they are seeing or hearing.
That's right.
They are going by supernatural faith.
SF.
This is it. Yes. Are you ready for the first one? Are you ready? Yes? Let's go there. First one.
Hello, my name is Ariel and I'm from the Edmonton branch. So before coming into quarantine, I was facing a lot of challenges within myself, a lot of challenges around me. So I had literally no way to escape, nothing. And I knew that I needed the Holy Spirit. I decided to look deep inside of myself and literally be sincere with God, give Him everything that I've ever held on to. So I will give my best in the services, the online services, the everything that I was doing, I will give Him my best. So it came down to Palm Sunday, just gone April the 5th, where it was time for us to seek for the Holy Spirit. And I had the opportunity to give God everything that was left of me, everything that was ever inside of me. I decided to give it to Him without holding back anything at all. And I remember when there was nothing else for me to literally give, nothing else, that assurance came inside of me. I was assured, 100% assured, that God came inside of me and he sealed me with that assurance. And I remember after finishing seeking the Holy Spirit, like, I felt very peaceful. You know, I wasn't agitated, I wasn't anxious. I just had assurance in me that God was inside of me. And from then onwards, things haven't been 100%, but I'm now able to fight the challenges that I'm facing now. And it's onwards and upwards from here. So this is my testimony. All the honor, all the glory goes to Him.
What a blessing. You see, Holy Spirit, the greatest blessing. May God bless you all from Edmonton.
That's it, Bishop. People of Edmonton in faith receiving the Holy Spirit. Amazing.
That's right. And you can also send us your testimony. Send it to My Testimony, as you can see there, at uckg.org. My Testimony at uckg.org. If it's easier, let's go for the easier one.
Yes.
We're not going to leave any exit for them now.
No.
We are putting people on the corner saying, you are going
to
do it for the glory of God.
They have to.
For their own good. You see, Pastor, what we are doing. We are leaving no alternative for them so they may do it and be blessed.
That's it. You have to be
like
blessed.
Those personal trainers that the guy says, I cannot take it anymore. One more.
Yes.
And when the person sees that he can do one more, he can see that he can.
Discovers a new strength that they didn't know they had before.
Pastor, let's see there the WhatsApp number.
WhatsApp number, 07857-956-941.
That's right. What are you waiting for? Send us your testimony. Determine there. Continue determining. You're going to be one testimony, one more. I can even say you're going to be the next testimony. Let's go for one more. Do you have one more then? So let's go.
Hello everyone, my name is Victoria and this is my testimony. I've been in the church for like a year and a couple months now, and I even got baptized in water last year, summer. But from that point onwards, I was just not doing what I was supposed to do. I was not giving my life to God. I was not being obedient. I was just doing my way. So 2 days ago, on Sunday, during the 10 a.m., I came determined. I even came fasting. I came determined that today I have to receive God's Spirit. I even challenged God and said, like, I'm not going back to sleep until I receive your Spirit, because I've given you everything that I could ever give. Like, there's nothing left. So I have to receive God's Spirit. And I seeked like I never seeked before. I even forgot I was at home. I forgot I was in a lockdown. I forgot about everything. When I attended 6 p.m. service, that's when God's Spirit came upon me and I got baptized by the Holy Spirit. It was just everything that I needed, was the power, just everything that I needed, that I've been seeking for. And I'm just so thankful to the church, of course, for the online services, for literally everything, even for the testimonies that are being played, which inspired me to just say that if they can, so can I. So that gave me the determination and the strength to just never give up and just give all of myself to God. And I did, and right now I'm blessed and I know God is with me.
One more. Who received the Holy Spirit? What a amazing blessing. Today is Holy Spirit all the way.
Yes, amazing. She said, I'm even not going to sleep until I receive the Holy Spirit. Challenge God. And
well, that's the faith.
That's it.
And it's revolt as well. Yes, see, this is revolt. When we talk about revolt, people start imagining people breaking up things. Yeah, I don't understand why. It's because of the worldly things we see there. They see those demonstrations and people breaking up things. This has nothing to do with the revolt of faith. A person in revolt is a person who doesn't accept seeing what is not according to God's will in his life.
Yes,
and will go until he sees the fulfillment of the promise of God. Does not give up.
Yes,
a person in revolt doesn't give up, like her.
That's right. Actually, when the revolt is of the faith, the more difficult it gets, the more resolve they have.
That's what people say, now I'm going to go.
Yes.
Now I'll go until the end.
It's an intelligent revolt.
That's right. Do you have one more? One is good, two is better, and three is the charm.
That's it.
Let's go. One more. And this one was from which branch again? Salvo. Yes, let me mention here, because people from Salvo say, what is happening? What about us? May God bless you, Salvo. Yes. God bless you all who are watching us there, and you all who are saying, I'll be the next testimony. We agree with you. Let's go. Next one.
My name is Malda. I attend South Hope Branch. Today, when Bishop was preaching about the rapture, and he told us it could be our last day today, we may not have a chance for tomorrow. So I made a decision to receive the Holy Spirit. I haven't heard about this only today. I have been fighting through my faith. And today the coin dropped. I said it has to be today. I'm not new in the church, but today I made a decision. And I seek the Holy Spirit, I seek the Holy Spirit, I seek the Holy Spirit. Pastors, I was seeking. I received that peace, I received that joy inside of me. I got the assurance that the Holy Spirit is inside of me. I'm so happy, I'm at peace. And I thank you, Jesus. I give you the glory and the honor. Thank you, Jesus, for this blessing in my life. What a day in my life. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
What a blessing. Just correcting, he gave me the wrong information. Wood Green, may God bless you. And now, Salvo.
Yes.
Now is Salvo.
Now is Salvo.
May God bless you all. What a blessing. Isn't it, Pastor Edwards?
It's amazing, Bishop. Strong. And people are using their faith. People are learning one thing through this lockdown, Bishop, which is really good.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit has to be the main focus. And those who are learning this, they are receiving God's Spirit.
Those who are wise. Because, Pastor Edwards, let's now go to the, let's speak bluntly now. They say bluntly, isn't it? Let's be blunt now, as they say. Those who are wise, they prioritize the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
It's biblical. And those who are foolish, acting foolishly, they don't. As simple as this, we are not trying to offend anybody. It's a biblical
direction.
Truth. It's a biblical truth. So you have to look at yourself and you have to be honest and ask yourself, am I acting wisely or foolishly?
That's right.
Am I prioritizing the baptism in the Holy Spirit, or am I prioritizing other blessings that are temporary?
That's right, Bishop. Because in the end of the day, the most important thing is to keep the salvation. How many people we know that have conquered so many things, right, Bishop?
And they were one of the greatest testimonies of the church in terms of blessings.
Yes, they were even known, you know, for the great things they've seen.
We cannot even play their testimonies anymore. Why?
Because they left the presence
of God. They are not in God's presence. So they are no longer a testimony.
That's right. They lost everything for not having the most important testimony of all.
Exactly. The Holy Spirit is vital. Again, Pastor Ed, the Holy Spirit is the main course, and people are treating the Holy Spirit like a dessert.
Yes. That's
what they do.
I know
I'm already full with the things of this life. I'm already focused on other things, and I'm leaving the Holy Spirit for the last thing. What did Jesus say there? Let's go there. Let's go there to the Bible. Pastor Edwards, let's go there to the words. Matthew 6:33. Look at that. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Excuse me, Pastor Edwards. I don't know if this is very complicated. Maybe it isn't, because maybe first means something else in a part
first
of the world that we didn't come from.
Yes.
As far as I know, first means first.
Yes.
Number one.
Top
in,
priority.
In Japan, in
anywhere
England,
in the world,
in
any
Africa,
language,
in South America, in
any culture, first the kingdom of God, the things of God, the Spirit of God.
Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. First, priority.
That's right.
See, first, that means it's the priority. What comes first? Like what I need to give attention first.
Yes.
Is what is spiritual here, isn't
it? That's right.
Spiritual life and
that's right.
What we have been saying from the beginning, the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
And then it says, and all these things, talking about the blessings, shall be added to you. And then Jesus says here, so nicely done, so nicely brought to us. Look, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, because that's the problem. People keep worrying. But what about my family?
Yes.
I am getting old and I didn't get married.
My career.
And my career. How am I going to do this and how am I going to do that? Therefore, don't worry about tomorrow. For tomorrow, we worry about its own things. Sufficient. Tell me about it, Pastor. Look what's coming. For the day is its own trouble.
Oh, my goodness. And people, they want to worry about the problem of yesterday.
Yes.
And then they want to put the problems of today.
And tomorrow.
And the problems of tomorrow, they will not even come, but they are already anticipating.
That's why they feel depressed and
saying,
and
the Holy Spirit, no, I need solution to this first. Oh, Bishop. Sometimes we feel like pulling the header off our head here because we, oh, my goodness, it's so clear.
It's clear, So remember, all you have to do now is this. Do you want your problems to be solved? Do you want your life to change? Do you want to see great results? Focus on the Holy Spirit. Once you have the Holy Spirit, now you have God inside of you who will guide you to all truth, who will direct you, who will help you to make the right choices, who will help you to overcome your problems. So the conclusion, the normal conclusion, do you want to solve your problems? First, receive the Holy Spirit.
That's it.
And then you are going to solve it. You're going to take possession of what you have never taken possession of.
Yes. They have two options. I try to solve them on my own.
Yeah.
Or I try to first have God inside of me through his Spirit and then go with him against my problems. It's a matter of choice. Which one would be the smarter one?
I'm not going to say anything anymore.
Wow.
Did you get it? So let's go for our last break now. And when we come back, you're going to come back without concerns and worries and fears and doubts. And if there is any sinful habit there, you better get rid of that. And I say you better, because if you come back with that and we seek here, nothing's going to happen. This is it. God has already told many of you, forgive. God has already showed you what you have to do, but maybe you are insisting in doing things your way and you are not helping. God is unable to do his work in the life of a person who is not surrendering his everything to him. So what is this that the Holy Spirit has already showed you that you should have done yesterday And you know what I mean, yesterday. So think about this. And now during this break, do it. Abandon. Let go. Surrender your all. Because tonight is going to be your night. You're going to send this week in the name of Jesus your testimony saying, I was baptized in the Holy Spirit that day that God used there the servants of his servants to indeed make me revolt against my situation and say, this is it. Enough of sin. Enough of not having a testimony. Enough of not doing what I have to do. Right. I will do it. This is it. We'll be right back.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
I would struggle within myself. I was even like afraid to sleep at night, like sleep paralysis and so forth. So I didn't really have peace when I was sleeping during the night.
I was someone who was very depressed. I had a lot of addictions, a lot of inside. I had full of complexes. I didn't believe in myself. And not only just that, but I was always angry. I had a lot of anger inside of me.
A lot of doubts would come inside of my mind because I've made my decision, which was very quick. Like I cut off everything. I sacrificed what I had to sacrifice. But then receiving the Holy Spirit was hard because inside of my mind, I still kind of had that weak mind.
So from then on, I said, okay, my God, it's all or nothing. There was a message I knew that God was speaking to me at that moment. So then I got revolted, I got angry, and I said, no, my God, it's either you baptize me now or you let me go.
When the Holy Spirit came, it was very straight to the point because I was so decided, like I didn't allow emotions, things to get in the way. Anything I would put my mind to, I would just achieve it because I know that God was with me, like he was inside of me. So nothing would stop me, nothing would, things would try, but I had power like within me to say, no, Tanusha, you can do this. You don't have to end up like this. And from then onwards, like it's just peaceful.
One advice I would give is be sincere with yourself and be sincere with God. If you really want God, give everything, not just half of you, not just 99% of you, 100% of you.
Don't ever give up because God promised. God is going to come. He is going to come. He's not a God that lies. It's just a matter of time. So it's for you to keep going. Like, don't give up and keep seeking God.
Inspired on Liberty Radio.
Now all you have to do is to ask. You who surrendered yourself there, you said, my Lord, I don't want to be the same. This is it. I let go of my past. I let go of what is not according to God's will. Now, all you have to do now is this. Lord, here I am. Surrender to you. Fill me. Renew me, revive me. He's going to come upon you. Let's do it now. Yes. Make your place your sanctuary. Join us and let's seek God together. Father, may you wash them now, cleanse them, those who made a decision now during the break and said, this is it. I abandon my sins. I let go of everything that separates me from Jesus. Now cleanse them. Wash them. Yes, and take away the doubts, the thoughts that keep saying you're never going to be filled with the Holy Spirit. This is not for you. You don't deserve. Come, Holy Spirit, come now to shut up the mouth of the lions. And may you come upon these people now. Whoever you are listening, I don't know who I am talking to. But if you seek God now with all of your heart, if you ask Him to fill you now, believing, you who are surrendering yourself to Him, if you say, come, Lord Jesus, fill me with your Spirit, He is going to do it right now. So go ahead. Use your faith there. Go in your faith now.
Thank you.
filled with the Holy Spirit, wherever you are. Be baptized right now. Be renewed. Be revived. Whoever you are who is believing now, believe. All you have to do is to believe. Be filled. Yes, there is an assurance inside of you that God is with you. It's happening. He is there. And He strengthens you. He lifts you up. Yes, He renews you. You are no longer the same. All your thoughts change. Desires, aspirations, your intentions, everything changes now. You become one with God, with the Holy Spirit, with Jesus. They are there with you. Yes, God is with you there. Be empowered. Hallelujah. Worship Him. Adore Him. Go ahead. Go ahead. Express to Him what is inside of you now. Worship You, my God. We glorify You. And again, we say we don't care about the things of this world. We don't care about what people say or think. We only care about one thing: pleasing You, knowing that You are happy with the way we are serving You, my Lord. Be glorified, be magnified. And my Lord, may You prosper Your people as well, meet their needs physically. Many people are struggling right now, but now may You touch the ravens. We bless all the ravens. We bless those who are right now meeting the needs of Your house. May You prosper them abundantly. Let them have the best, my Lord. We determine their victory now in everything, in Jesus Christ's name. And you who agree, say amen. You are blessed. Pastor Edwards, now I believe all people have to do is to put into practice, isn't it?
That's it, Bishop. The message has been given, and now it's only to continue going in this journey.
Remain this faith.
Yes.
And those who are still in doubt, those who have not yet been baptized in the Holy Spirit, they have to continue seeking.
Continue seeking. It's going to happen.
That definitely. Because if I told you that by digging at that corner there, you would find a diamond that would change your life forever, if you dig for 1 hour and you didn't find it, you would not stop it.
Yes, right.
You wouldn't stop, isn't it? You would go until you found it, because I told you it's there. Sometimes it seems like it's not there.
Yes.
But God said it is there. That's God said, seek Me with all of your heart and you find
Me. That's right? It's a promise, Bishop.
It's a promise. So continue. Continue devoting yourself. Continue pleasing God daily. Every single day, continue asking this question: Lord, what do I do to please You more? As we mentioned, continue feeding yourself with divine knowledge. Knowledge that brings you close to God, right? Get rid of those knowledges that do not help you, that contaminate your faith.
That are unprofitable, right?
Definitely.
It's knowledge, but distance is one from
yes.
God.
And you're going to find much more than receiving the Holy Spirit. You're going to find new things. God's going to reveal new things to you as He promised.
That's right, Bishop.
Right?
And the more we remain in that realm of staying in the Word, staying in the knowledge of God, the stronger we get.
As you saw, some people were asking, this fast of Daniel will last until what? Until when? See, they are already bored.
Yes, that's right.
Because we have a question like this. You know, I answered that question. Whoever put it there, may God bless you. But I answered that question with sadness in my heart.
Yes.
Because I said, why this question now? When is it going to finish? I don't want it to finish. Never.
Yeah, it's like I'm doing a fast and I'm saying, okay, all right, I'm
look, I'm hungry.
Hours. Oh,
it's
God,
like people,
make
imagine,
the time go faster.
Yeah, it's like people are saying, come on, this fast of dinner is taking too long. I want to go back to the world. I want to go back to dirtiness. I want to go back to promiscuity. Look, if that's what you want, we are not going to stop you. God's not going to stop you. The fast of Daniel will last as long as the lockdown lasts. Ah, but it's going to last 2 more months or 3 more months. So be it.
It's gone.
And thank God for that.
Yes, that's good. Bishop. My goodness. That's protecting us.
Thank God for that.
How many people, they know nothing of the fast of Daniel, but they are out there depressed, anxious, suicidal, full of problems.
That's right.
We can be in the realm of God's protection. God speaking to us, staying in the light. It's amazing.
So whoever have ears to hear, we are talking to you. Those who want to break the fast of Daniel, those who don't want to stay, we don't want you to go. But remember, you have your freedom of choice. But those who are going to stay with us until the end, they're going to be the next testimonies, by the way, Pastor Edward.
They will be the one next one sending us the videos and they receive the Holy Spirit.
So be wise. Come on. Don't be influenced by the people who are not taking it seriously. Have a person who has his own personality, or you know, his own mind made up. I will follow God no matter what. If people abandon him, if my family leaves him, if people I love leaves Jesus, I will stay with Jesus because he is the love of my life.
And Bishop, the faith is personal. One of the worst things we can do is to be there listening to others. And because maybe somebody doesn't have the faith to do it, fine.
That's right.
But they shouldn't be the one saying, you know, this is taking too long, huh? But this is where the problem begins. If they don't have the faith to obey, fine. But respect those who have faith to obey.
Pastor Edwards, I have the faith to keep the faith, Pastor Edwards.
I too, Bishop.
Let's go all the way.
Amen.
We're going to go today. And those who is coming with us, let's go until we enter the New Jerusalem. And don't forget, this Sunday, as you can see here behind us, we're going to have this special purpose, the throne of grace, as it's written there. Have a look there. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. This is a time of distress, a time of crisis, a time of need. So God is inviting us to come boldly to his throne, and he will have mercy and will help us.
Yes.
He will do what others were not able to do. So this Sunday at 10 a.m. sharp on our online services, we're going to come boldly before the throne of grace, knowing that we are going to receive what we haven't received yet. The help we need, God is going to give it to us. All right? So see you tomorrow here at the same time. And don't forget, throughout the day, 8 o'clock, we have the Love Therapy tomorrow.
8 o'clock, Bishop,
Online, isn't it?
Online Love Therapy tomorrow, 8 p.m.,
Don't forget, invite your friends, invite people. And every single day, throughout the week. And it's important. And this is what everybody should be doing from Monday to Monday, connecting at least once a day. If you cannot in the morning, go for the evening, afternoon. We want people to be on the main meetings, yes, but there will be days you cannot, but at least once a day, connect. Don't forget, don't distance yourself from the source of life, all right? Have a wonderful day, afternoon, evening. God bless you wherever you are. Bye-bye.
Come, Holy Spirit, to touch me, to hold me, to be in your presence is everything I need, the truest friend to me. I raise my hands to worship you, to surrender all my heart to you. As broken as I am, you love me, you love me. As wretched as I am, you love me, you love me. Jesus, in your love, you died on the cross for me. The burden of my sins you took away. You healed my pain and gave me life. Jesus, in your love, you died on the cross for me. The burden of my sins you took away. You healed my pain and gave me life. Jesus. Precious.